Joanne, I'd like to ask you, how was it that you decided to start the Bible study group?
Well, I took a Bible study. I've been to several Bible study groups, but this one especially that I went to did an overview of the Bible and gave me a closer idea of what went on in the Old Testament. I have a better knowledge and understanding of what the story is about.
Okay, you've taken several Bible study groups, so then the study of the Bible is important to you.
It's very important to me. It brings me closer to know Jesus. We can study the Bible and know about Jesus. We could read the Bible and know about Jesus, but if you study the Bible, then you know who Jesus is. It's like if you meet someone on the street and you ask them, what is your name? Well, you know about them, you know what their name is, but it isn't until that person starts talking to you and you interact with them that you know who they are, and you can have a better relationship with them. So with the Bible study, we have a personal relation. We can acquire a personal relationship with Jesus Christ.
Okay. And speaking of personal relationship, how is it that your Bible discussions are conducted?
Well, we're not a very structured group because I like to leave everything open for discussion. And we'll read the Bible passage and a commentary on the Bible, commentary on the passage. And then I tell everybody that as we're reading, if something comes to them, to remember to say it so that we can discuss it, because I think that the Holy Spirit speaks through all of us and we can learn from each other.
Does anybody come with an attitude to study the Bible and saying that the Bible is boring to me?
I don't know that anybody's ever said that, but I think that if you are only reading the Bible, I mean, atheists read the Bible from cover to cover and it's boring to them.
Right.
But if you have a desire to know God, then it's not boring to you. It can't be boring with all the different characters and things that go on in the Old Testament with people taking over cities and things like that. That it's not boring. What's good about it is I do the Liturgy of the Hours every day, and we read the Psalms. And when the Psalms, when they say some of the cities in the Psalms, because I've studied that in the Bible, I know what the cities are, what they're talking about.
Right.
You know, what's happened at that time, why was he saying that city at that time?
And in your Bible study groups, do you have fun group discussions?
Yeah, we do. We tease with each other just horse around.
Okay. If someone is interested in joining the Bible study group, can you take more people?
Oh yeah, the more people we have, the better it is, because the more discussion we have.
Right.
I mean, you get different points of view and different slants on the same story.
How is it that someone can find out when you hold your Bible studies?
Well, I guess they can call the church, and the father will get a hold of me, and we can tell them when they can come, and we'll be very happy to get a big, active group going.
So, in other words, the more people you have, the merrier.
The more, the merrier. Yes.
Sounds like a real good discussion group.
Yeah, I think so. And the other people that are in there, when we took some time off now, and people are asking, well, when's it going to start again? When's it going to start again?
They miss it when they're not there.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
We have a great time.
Glad to hear that. Keep up the good work.
Thank you.